Ms. Valerie Abati has been checking items off her bucket list, the Cincinnati bucket list. Well, tonight, she put on her gym shoes, pulled out her bike, or got a bike, to check out the Little Miami Scenic Trail.
Well, it's one of the nicest days we've seen in such a long time, so I want to get outside and check off another item on the Cincinnati bucket list. And we're here at the Little Miami Scenic Trail at the actual trailhead right here in Newtown. It started as a railroad. Now it's a 78-mile path connecting some of the tri-state's unique towns.
It is neat. It's so interesting to be able to go to the different little towns and see what all, you know, they have to offer.
The entire trail is flat, so you'll see people of all ages, as well as all fitness levels.
Loved it. Carter, what do you think about it?
Pretty. Jackie Mullins is out for the day with her grandson. Their 17-mile trip is more than just biking.
We stopped over at the candy store, which is the cutest little candy store.
You don't have to start at the beginning. You'll find access points from Milford to King's Mills, all the way to Springfield.
Today we're going to try to go to Lebanon.
If you don't want to walk the trail and you don't have your own bike, stop here at the Loveland Bike Rental, where you can take one for half a day or make an entire day of it. Owner Janice Lawler says she sees people come from all around.
It really varies depending on the weather, but typically between 20 to 50 weekdays and between 50 to 100 probably on a weekend.
As one of the longest paved trails in the U.S., it's one you can't miss.
I definitely on the bucket list. Yeah, people are really missing something, missing out if they don't come out here and see the trail because it's beautiful.
Okay, so maybe I didn't go the whole way, but that's a great thing about this trail is that you can make it as short or as long as you want. Valerie Abati, News 5.